You mentioned to me earlier about what you're doing on your Wednesday nights. I think this is fascinating. If there's pastors watching, they need to learn, I believe. This is a great idea, guys. Listen to this.
Yeah, we decided that our Wednesday nights, you know, most churches are used to their Sunday mornings, and then they have their Wednesday night Bible study, and they have all the other almost para ministries, the things that are on the side, tucked away, and they're, that's not bad per se. But God began to deal with our hearts to realize that in the Bible, if you do your study about history, Jesus called the disciples. Peter was around the age of 20 to 21, but most of the disciples were teenagers, around 14 to 18. So
here's this,
the men
this,
we know.
This is the historical part that we don't hear about. This is why, exactly, I want to do this thing on Good Friday, because we don't understand this.
Exactly. And for us, we just decided if Jesus began with the youth, why would we relegate them, ooh, to be away from the main sanctuary until they're 18 and somehow then useful for church, realizing, mm-hmm, that they are the church. So we've decided as a church that on our Wednesdays, we're going after the young people of the community, not with just a youth pastor or some youth leaders,
yeah,
but as an entire church, going after the young in our community, worshiping together so they can be standing right there with the adults. Because, yeah, the Bible says older men raise up the younger men, older women raise up the younger women. And how do we expect them to become the church that God has called us to be if we're not imparting what he has first imparted to us? So it's a kingdom thinking. We have to get our minds out of the box of Western church, see the gospel in the historical record, knowing what the Spirit of God wants to do, and being willing to say yes, and here's the hard part, even making some church members mad because it riles up their traditions. But I've always said this, for some people, tradition is thicker than truth. But if we will hold the line as strong leaders to let the truth prevail, the signs, the wonders, the miracles will completely convince the hardened of heart that the kingdom way is truly God's way.